We have our heading.
Here we go!
From the magic within our hearts to the adventure beyond the horizon, there is only one Disney.
This Disney DVD is enhanced with Disney's Fast Play. Your movie and a selection of bonus features will begin automatically. To bypass Fast Play, select the main menu button at any time. Fast Play will begin in a moment.
Enter a new world of home entertainment where the movies look sharper. The action feels closer.
Whoa, whoa, whoa!
Where the movies you want and the games you play are on Disney Blu-ray High Definition.
Everything changes.
It's the ultimate cinematic experience with superior full high definition picture with up to 6 times the resolution of DVD and superior full high definition surround sound.
Perfect!
Plus, Blu-ray's protective layer resists scratching. And Blu-ray discs play on PlayStation 3 game systems. And with innovative bonus features, get more Disney magic.
Hooray!
And more of your favorite movies than ever before. Disney Blu-ray.
Hey!
Magic in high definition.
What's going on here?
Little puppet made of pine, wait.
I can move.
Oh, look, Father, look!
Well, it's about time.
Of all the planets in our universe, there is only one that we know can support life. It's called Earth. Disney Nature Films proudly presents a BBC Greenlight Media and Discovery Channel production of an extraordinary motion picture event about 1 year in the life of the creatures who share our planet.
It's the biggest buddy event of the year.
You guys, check out Dad's first starring role.
Coming soon to Disney DVD, the original classic, Air Bud, on an all-new special edition DVD.
Whoa, is that Dad?
He looks so young.
I only run that fast when someone yells dinner. Check out Dad playing ball.
He's definitely the game's MVP, most valuable paw.
With exclusive bonus features, including an all-new Buddy's commentary.
Hey, he's talking about us. Dad chases the ball like it's the mailman. Dude, the fur is really flying.
Now I know where I got my moves from.
Their teamwork is in perfect harmony.
Get your paws on the movie that started it all. The original classic, Air Bud Special Edition.
Can someone cover that dog?
For the first time on Disney DVD, March 3rd, 2009.
That's what I call an OC. An original classic, y'all. Looks like we come from a pretty great pedigree.
The movie you're watching right now is Magic. And the magic continues after the credits. Just look inside your DVD or Blu-ray disc for the magic code to start earning points toward fantastic rewards at DisneyMovieRewards.com.
I think I swallowed a space fly.
Oh, haha, very funny, guys, very funny.
Whoa, whoa!
Buddies, you're right in the middle of a meteor shower.
A shower? My contract says no shower scenes. I'm out of here.
Cut! Somebody get my Bud's agent on the phone. And action! Cut! Cut! That was perfect, Mud Bud.
Are you sure? I think I can improve on it. Let's do it again.
Rolling. Action!
Dudes, I saw the Jamaican bobsled team do this. Push! Now that I think of it, it didn't work out so well for the Jamaican bobsled team either.
Take two.
The dog's down for the count.
What a shame, because these space nachos are gnarly.
Butterball.
Huh? Huh? Is it lunchtime already?
Action!
Come on, buddy.
All right, cut. Cut! Instruction. We're going to need a bigger doggy door.
Yes, like in a fairy tale. Whoa, oh, you took my beer, though.
Cut! Trainers, Butterball just ate Rosebud's bow.
It's an alien!
Dude, there's no aliens.
Action. Cut. B-Dog, don't eat the glasses.
Tad Thompson!
Did you hit me?
I did.
Cut!
Yo-hoo!
I'm still here. Oh, it's me! Hello, everyone.
Oh, it's wonderful! Oh, you're beautiful!
Last one on the ship smells like Yuri's space juice.
Watch out!
Hey, no fair, dogs!
Butterball has one last question.
Not really a question.
I gotta take a whiz or something fierce.
You gotta be kidding me, dog.
Butterball, what are you doing?
Action. Run, B-Dog, run. B-Dog, run.
No way. It's raining cats out there, dog. I'll be catching some Z's in my trailer if you need me.
Cut.
Whoa, 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 whoa.
Butterball, and cut. All right, that's a wrap, folks.
We're having fun most every night. When that old moon gets big and bright, it's a supernatural delight. Everybody was dancing in the moonlight. Everybody here is out of sight. They don't bargain, they don't bite, they keep things loose, they keep things alive. Everybody was dancing in the
One small step for dog, one giant leap for dog kind.
Whoa, dudes and dudettes! My bud here with the rest of the buddies.
We're here to tell you all about what it was like making the movie and share some super cool facts about space.
So pull up a chair and get ready to learn all about it in T-minus 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Blast off!
It takes a lot of training to balance your chi. That's why I did a lot of yoga to prepare for breaking free of Earth's gravity. It looks like we were actually flying in space, but that's the magic of special effects. You may think we blasted off, but all of our scenes in space were filmed in front of a green screen. A green screen is simply when a wall behind all the action is bright green. See? After the scene is filmed, the visual effects department uses computers to replace the green background with whatever background they want. In this case, a lunar landscape. Without their hard work, we couldn't have become space buddies.
Wow, the moon!
Buddies, are you ready to go for the walk of your lives?
In this shot, we appear to join our new pal Sputnik for a walk on the moon. But we really are right here on Earth.
Whoa, wait a minute, Doc. Everybody told me we were really in space. What about when we were floating with that zero-grav stuff?
What's happening?
That's where wires come in. We had to learn to balance in midair, supported by strong wires attached to our spacesuits. Spending all that time off the ground was very enlightening and a lot of fun.
This is incredible.
You can say that again. Even I'm lighter than a feather.
But our preparation for Space Buddies was nothing compared to the rigorous training real astronauts go through. While we were simulating weightlessness using wires, astronauts are sent up in an airplane nicknamed the Weightless Wonder, or the Vomit Comet, for those who lose their lunch.
Lunch is a terrible thing to lose. I'll skip that ride, thank you very much.
It's not just a ride, Butterball. They do it so the astronaut can practice floating and other zero-G maneuvers without going all the way to outer space. Another way to train for lack of gravity is not in the air, but underwater. This environment allows astronauts to practice procedures in conditions very similar to weightlessness.
You mean you've got to take a bath to be an astronaut?
These procedures include practicing a spacewalk to repair problems outside the shuttle, just like Butterball did in the movie.
Oh, sweet mama, this is beautiful.
That's just a small part of the training. All in all, it takes almost 2 years to become officially ready to hop into a spacesuit. And speaking of spacesuits,
check out the fly gear.
Oh my gosh, these outfits are so to die for. Okay, let's talk about fashion that's out of this world. One of my favorite things about our new movie was the spacesuits we got to wear. Will one of you boys zip me up? We had some of the best costume designers around, and they knew a thing or two about space glamour. They wanted to make them practical for us puppies, but also have them be totally fashionable for space. The pink one definitely suits me best. I mean, just look at how it matches my bow. Plus, pink is the hot color this season. This is more like it. The blue suit goes with pretty much anything, and really brought out the dogmanot in all of us buddies.
Mine's a little too tight. Someone give me a paw.
Don't pull his paw!
Sputnik was definitely working his orange spacesuit, and he even got this adorable matching hat to wear. Very chic. The first American spacesuits were based on the suits of the pilots in jet aircrafts, because astronauts needed to be able to move around while wearing them. These first suits were very bulky, and some weighed about 250 pounds. That's not too bad in space, though, because everything is weightless. And they wear a backpack called an extravehicular mobility unit, or EMU for short. It's not designer label, but without it, they wouldn't be able to breathe. With the life support backpack, they have enough air and water for 6 to 8 hours. Though, I don't recommend powering it on your own emissions.
I don't know what you guys are always complaining about. It's really not that bad.
Now, where was I? Oh. Space fashion, much like real fashion, has gone through a lot of changes since the first space explorers. Spacesuit designers like NASA's Amy Ross, daughter of astronaut Jerry Ross, came up with new innovations that will be used on future missions, like the new gloves Amy helped design for spacewalks. Her job is totally awesome. She not only makes the suits, but gets to try them out. Amy hopes to see a suit she envisioned on the surface of Mars someday. You go, girl. I think we're getting further and further away from home.
And further away from dinner. You can eat all you want in space and still be weightless. At least that's what they tell me. I know that I ate everything but the kitchen sink on this set, and I pretty much felt the weight of all of it. That's for sure. Our ship on Space Buddies had some very high-tech gizmos on it. But the best, in my opinion, was the Lunch-O-Matic. It's a pup's dream come true.
Piece of cake.
Yeah, there's cake. Ooh, donut. But I think I'll start with the chili cheese dog. Then steak. and finish with a bean burrito.
If you're looking for a snack, you just press your paw to the screen, and in a second, you've got a bean burrito, chili dog, or whatever you want. Sure, it doesn't quite look like the real thing because it's freeze-dried. But believe me, it tastes like it. All the flavors of a chili dog, plus added nutrients to make a growing pup strong. From the earliest space missions to the current menu on the International Space Station, space cuisine has changed a lot. John Glenn, the first astronaut to orbit the Earth, was also the first to experiment with eating in the weightlessness of space. He found swallowing to be no problem, but getting the food to his mouth was a different story, because of zero gravity.
Sounds like that job is right up your alley, bro. You've never had a problem getting food to your mouth.
Nowadays, an astronaut's menu has a lot of food that we have down on Earth, like brownies or macaroni and cheese. Sweet mama. But no matter what they're eating, it's important for astronauts to keep healthy. Sure, it would be great to just eat junk food all the time in space, but it's even more important to get your vitamins and exercise.
Yo, dog, the only exercise I've seen you do is run into the fridge.
You calling me fat? Mom says that I'm just big boned.
Where's the beef?
Anyway, when you're up in space, your bones and muscles can get weak from hardly being used, because you're always floating. Astronauts run on a special treadmill with straps attached to them to keep them from floating away, as well as other exercises every day to keep their bones and muscles strong.
Whoa, it's amazing.
I would have blinged it out a little more. In space, your ride has got to be super fly, yo. So when I found out we were blasting off for our next adventure, I had to make sure our ship was going to be blinged out.
Guys, I think we might be going on a road trip.
Yo, my production peeps designed the look of the Vision 1.
Ignition.
But I wanted to make sure it looked tight.
Oh, we're moving!
Being the fastest pup around, I had to know what was under the hood. Because escaping the Earth's atmosphere takes speeds of thousands and thousands of miles per hour.
That was a radical ride.
It's all good, though. There's no speed limit in space.
Atlantis, Houston, go at throttle up.
Go at throttle up.
Three engines on board back at full throttle. Atlantis now traveling more than 1,000 miles per hour.
It's not just what you got on the outside of your ride, though. You need some fly stuff on the inside. I was like, dogs, where's the hot tub go? I guess hot tubs don't work in a weightless environment. I did get to wear some slick shades that they call vector glasses.
Dude, you shouldn't be touching those.
They weren't just for style, though. They helped me pilot the ship.
Whoa, weird.
I've got mad piloting skills, dogs.
I don't know about mad, but my stomach certainly wasn't happy.
Now, space rides have come a long way. And it all started in 1957, when the Soviet Union launched a satellite called Sputnik.
The name's Sputnik.
That must be where our new friend Sputnik got his name.
For shizzle, bro. That started what's called the Space Race, a race that took nearly 20 years to finish. On July 21st, 1969, astronauts Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin became the first people to do the moonwalk.
That's one small step for man, one for
gotta give mad props to them. Back in those days, the astronauts would ditch most of the spacecraft's parts on the trip and would end up with only a capsule about the size of a car. That would fall back down to Earth and land in the ocean. This was called a splashdown.
Sounds like it should be a ride over at Disneyland.
And in 1981, the U.S. Space Agency started using the Space Shuttle, which is still used today. Unlike older space rides, this one landed like an airplane and could be reused for another trip. That's pretty fly, yo. But these days, NASA isn't the only ones blinging out rides for space travel. Soon, thanks to commercial space companies, we might all get to do the moonwalk for reals.
Check it. I'm doing the moonwalk.
Dudes, I'm here to tell you how we went green in space. We may have traveled into space in this adventure, but Earth is still my favorite place to be. It's where all the mud is. All the space dudes think Earth's great too, and they want to make sure it stays that way.
Dudes, what is this place?
Whatever it is, it's getting closer.
On our way to the moon, we made a stop at this gnarly space station run by a wacky Russian named Yuri.
American Blue Jeans, Godzilla, how are you?
Yuri.
Larry had this radical garden where he made his own oxygen and food. He's a vegan, just like Buddha.
The added benefit is the plants filter out CO2 gas and produce oxygen. And we also use them to create fuel for the station.
You can think of a spacecraft like its own ecosystem, just like Earth. So it's all about sustainability, which means taking what we need to live without using up all the natural resources. Soon, we'll try to go further than we've ever gone in space, to other planets and beyond. And we'll need to be able to grow fruits and vegetables in outer space, so astronauts can stay healthy.
Yeah, if you like broccoli, ugh, you need to grow some chili dogs.
The biggest challenge for me, though, is the lack of dirt. What's up with that?
Come on, Mudbud. We gotta go.
Oh, yeah. Much better. Did you know one thing space explorers are looking for is mud? Really, they're looking for any signs of water. They even thought there might be some on the moon, but could never find any. So they turned their attention to Mars.
Mars? Aren't there, like, Martians there?
Not that anyone has found yet, B-Dog. The science dudes think if they can find water, that'll mean the planet could support other life forms like us.
Whoa. What a concept, dudes.
Wouldn't it be cool to roll around in some Martian mud? Maybe someday we will. In the meantime, thanks for blasting off with us, buddies. We sure had fun. For now, keep green and keep watching the stars, dudes and dudettes.
Yes! Yes! We're home!
Now available on Disney DVD, The Big City Adventure with a little twist. Oliver.
Oliver?
Oliver!
Inspired by Charles Dickens' acclaimed story, Oliver Twist.
What do you say we team up?
Yeah!
It's the 20th anniversary edition of Walt Disney's classic, Oliver and Company.
And you got your pals, you got all you need.
With all the action.
They've kidnapped Oliver.
Don't worry, we'll get him back.
All the fun.
Let's do it.
And all the unforgettable memories.
Hey, you're okay for a cat.
Plus fantastic bonus features, including an all-new game.
Hey, man, check it out.
Walt Disney's classic Oliver and Company.
You can do anything.
I can?
Absolutely, positively.
The 20th anniversary edition, now available on Disney DVD.
My friends, my name is Papi. Viva Chihuahuas! We have been dressed in sweaters and carried in purses. I say, no más. I am tired of the jokes about our size. We will not be toys or fashion accessories. We will not answer to Fifi or Fufu. No más! Viva Chihuahuas!
Nothing can prepare you for the rise of the Chihuahuas. Beverly Hills Chihuahua.
Who is with me?
Coming soon to Disney DVD and Blu-ray High Def.
Hello?
Penny, I don't have much time.
Daddy?
I don't understand.
It's okay, Penny. You have Bolt.
I've altered him.
He can protect you now.
Bolt, speak.
Get that dog!
Nice move. Bolt!
You'll never see Penny again! And cut!
He's the star of the biggest show in Hollywood.
She's still in danger.
The only problem is...
Hold on, Penny!
He thinks it's all real.
Don't let him out! He's never been off the set before! I'm coming, Penny!
Production of the hit television show Bolt shut down today when its star dog went missing.
Oh.
You look
look familiar.
What?
Yeah, he's real good with the faces and such.
I gotta remember. It's gonna kill me. Hold on. No, I don't know. I thought I knew.
I need someone close to the green-eyed man. A cat.
Wow, it's a good knot. Were you in the Navy?
Well, I'll release you, cat. When we find Penny.
Cat, slow down! You're scraping the fur off my...
He must be so scared.
Bolt's not scared of anything.
You're Bolt, the super dog!
Where's Penny? She was kidnapped by the green-eyed man, but I've captured this cat.
Oh, you're crazy, man!
She's taking me to Penny.
I can be a valuable addition to your team.
The road will be rough.
I have a ball.
Easy will be part of the equation.
Promise.
Danger at every turn.
I eat danger for breakfast.
You hungry?
Starving.
How do you say no way I'm doing this in crazy?
Let it begin.
One unlikely team.
Look, genius, you're not a super dog.
Is on a mission to get back home.
Bolt is lost. He could be anywhere by now.
I feel alive!
And a new Disney comedy event.
Bolt!
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 Is about to be unleashed.
Super Bar! Super Bar!
We need a fast set of wheels.
I'll get my ball.
Bolt.
Come there! Let it begin! Let it begin!
All new on Disney DVD. What does it take to make a musical celebration? 100 Acres, 7 new original songs, and all your favorite friends.
Are you thinking what I'm thinking?
It's My Friends Tigger and Pooh. Tigger and Pooh in a musical too.
We need drummin' and strummin' and blowin'.
Join the Super Sleuths.
The Super Sleuths are on the case.
In their all new full-length movie.
Awesome.
Featuring tons of bouncing bonus features.
Bouncing in the rain. Hoo. Bouncing. I'm in love with you.
Do you like the sounds of adventure?
It'll be fantastic. Stupendable.
Then you'll love My Friends Tigger and Pooh. Tigger and Pooh in a musical too. In an all new movie. Coming soon to Disney DVD.
I can't wait.
My Friends Tigger and Pooh.
As fairies bring autumn to the world, a new adventure arrives. Legend tells of a precious moonstone, the most powerful source of magic in Pixie Hollow. But now, this great force is in danger. And with the help of her friends, Tinkerbell's quest will begin. Beyond Pixie Hollow and discover Tinkerbell and the Lost Treasure. Coming soon to Disney DVD and Blu-ray.
Twas the night before Christmas when all through the house not a creature was stirring. Not even a...
Shh! Butterball, what are you doing?
I was just gonna have one bite, I swear.
Dude, you know those are for the Jolly One.
He knows if you've been naughty or nice.
And that's pretty naughty.
Yo, the big dog won't come inside if any puppies are awake.
Quick, hide!
Disney's Santa Buddies, The Search for Santa Paws. Coming soon to Disney DVD and Blu-ray High Def.
Introducing Playhouse Disney's newest show, Imagination Movers. Join them as they jump, shout, and figure things out.
Have you got a situation that needs imagination?
When it comes to using your imagination to solve it all, these four big thinkers are the ones to call.
Yeah! Yeah!
Another idea emergency solved!
Yeah!
So get to know Mover Rich, Mover Dave, Mover Scott, Mover Smitty, and all their friends. Watch Imagination Movers, a rockin' new TV show on Playhouse Disney, every morning at 10, 9 Central.
You
got it going on. You got it
going on.
You got it going on.
Squad.
You got it going on. Let's get it go. Let's have some fun, alright.
Alright.
Put your spot, so step out in the spotlight.
What up, dog?
Get your strut on. Go ahead, now wag that tail. Now let me hear you roar. Say what you gotta say.
Okay.
We having fun today. We'll show them how the dogs play. We're gonna set it off.
Okay.
We will be off the chain.
You know
this is the dog's round. Will we have a dog day?
Give
me a doggy's name. For my dog bag. Now when my dog's at.
your cereal box. Shut up a garbage lid and don't leave the kitchen left unattended. Hamburgers burn, hamburgers soggy. It's all good when you're the doggy.
When you're the doggy,
I savor a flavor. I be feeling a favor. Triscuit, a Tasker. I'll even eat the basket. I'll eat your phony, baloney, or even macaroni. A toy telephone, it makes the perfect doggy day. Perfect doggy day.
A pair out there walking everywhere. I just whistle and you run, always out there having fun. Never knew it feels so right till there was you in black and white. All that I was dreaming of, I get from your
rabbits in my sleep. I wanna be a puppy
dog. Ruff, 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 a puppy dog. I wanna be a puppy dog. Ruff, 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 a puppy dog.
I'd play outside and jump in the lake. I'd sleep in your bed and lick your face awake. Cat, clear up in the tree. Fetch a ball, how happy I would be. You'd scratch my ears, I'd lay at your feet. I'd growl at the door and chase rabbits in my sleep.
I wanna be a puppy dog.